This is a tutorial about how to install WordPress themes into a standard WordPress website. Over here on the left, we have the WordPress website we've created, which is blank from our last video. In fact, there was a sequence of three videos, one showing hosting through GoDaddy, another showing how to buy a domain name or URL through GoDaddy and attach it to the hosting, and a third, once you've done that, showing how to do a WordPress install using that GoDaddy account. And that leaves us here. On the left-hand side, we have the front of the website that the public sees, timlevyandassociates.com in this case, which is all empty and looking pretty basic. And over here we have the login to WordPress, which is kind of known as the back end. This is where everything interesting happens. So let's log in. When you first log into a WordPress website, it has all kinds of interesting options here, but I'm going to kind of get rid of them all so I'm not worried about all of that sort of automatic stuff. This is kind of a good base point here. And what we want to do is we want to install a theme. So where are they actually? Let's click on this button so we can see the left-hand navigation a bit more clearly. And what you'll see here is under appearance, you see themes. That's where we're going. And what you'll see is that the standard themes, which were written by WordPress over the course of the last 2-3 years, 2015, 14, 13, are there. And this one here, 2015, is active. But we want to upload something new. So we click on Add New. When we do that, it starts to show us all kinds of other themes, which are all available to you. But in our case, we've all actually bought one from a website called Themeforest. And I just want to show you this. We have another tutorial on this. Feel free to go to YouTube, type in Themeforest tutorial. You'll find our tutorial there, or click on a link in the description below. The reason I like Themeforest themes is I know that they've been worked on over the course of time and improved and improved and improved. In our particular case, we're using a theme called Avada, which is the sort of the number one top-selling WordPress theme, this one here, of all time. And you can see that if you want to buy it, it's $58 and you can install it, which we've just done offline. So we've got that Avada theme ready to go and downloaded as a zip file. So we go over here on the right and we click on Upload Theme and we hit Browse so we can go find the file. And here it is. And that file gets installed like so. Now, amazingly, that is it. That theme is now being installed. With the Avada theme in particular, there are a few more steps to go through because it has some additional plugins and bits and pieces. So I'll show you that briefly, but installing a theme is as quick as that, no matter what the theme is. Let's pause for a moment while this continues uploading. I'll come back in a second. Okay, that was probably 20 seconds, which shows you how impatient I am. And now we've got this theme, we hit activate. As soon as we hit activate, that theme becomes live. But what it's also telling you here is that it wants to install some extra plugins. So in this case, let's allow it to do that. We go into its system, we add this thing called Fusion Core, which adds basically quite dramatic functionality. And then we're going to add, we'll activate it. Then we'll add this one here called Layer Slider, which is one of those sliding systems that allows images to slide and move around and do fun animated things. And then we'll activate it too. And then the last one it wants us to play with is this one here, which is the another slider called the Revolution Slider. Certainly this is one that we use all the time at the top of most of our home pages and some of our other pages too. So once we've got all of those done, now Avada is happy. And when we go back to the dashboard, we see that's done and, oh, it wants us to activate the Revolution Slider because I forgot to do that, my bad. And click on activate. So it really does walk you through what's meant to happen. Now, if we go over here to the website, which you'll recall, if we reload that, it's now going to look totally different. Same data, but it looks different. And now it's got that Avada theme going. From this point, you can start to go in and customize the theme and background and colors and logos and all those other fun things. And that is as simple as it is to upload a theme to WordPress. So if you've liked this video, please by all means click on the like button. Always love your comments and questions in the comments section below. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so. Other than that, we'll see you with our next video coming right up.